Hello, wonderful people, and how are you all doing today? It's a beautiful, beautiful Saturday evening, and I'm so glad to be back on our channel, The Vision Guide. If you are a subscriber, thank you for subscribing. Thank you for always coming back to watch our videos. And if you're a new subscriber, thank you for subscribing. And if you are just seeing my face for the first time, please kindly consider subscribing. My name is Oye. Oye Layo, and I am your parenting coach. So this is the Parenting Essentials, where we get tips, keys on how to have a successful parenting, and it comes your way every Saturday. So if you're new here, you can go on and check our playlist. You're gonna see varieties of what we have on our channel. Kindly please support us by subscribing, by watching our videos, by commenting, and by sharing our video. We highly appreciate that. From my last video, where I showed some activities that you can do with your child at home, if you have not seen the last video, I'm gonna drop the link somewhere here. You can just go ahead and see that after you finish watching this. It's gonna help you a lot. It's gonna give you some ideas of activities that you can actually do with your child or children at home. So the link is gonna be somewhere around here. Can't you just go ahead and click the link after this video and just watch the video? It's going to help you a lot. All right, in my last video, I mentioned I'm gonna give you some idea or some alarming signs in children that you can look out for. Please note, in case you see any of these signs I'm gonna mention, it doesn't mean that your child is autistic. It doesn't mean your child is on the spectrum. But if you are not sure or you are bothered, you can as well go ahead and check with a pediatrician, or you can check with a specialist. Don't forget that early intervention is the key. Early intervention is the key. If you're concerned about a particular thing in your child, maybe how your child's speech, the walking, whatever you're concerned with, or whatever I'm gonna mention to you this evening, if you're really concerned, don't just overlook it. Just go ahead and check with your doctor, check with a pediatrician or a specialist. And they can actually evaluate your child and give you exactly what might be the issue. And don't forget, in case there's any issue, early intervention is the key. Don't forget, these signs does not automatically mean that your child is on the spectrum. All right? This is just a sign that you have to watch closely to ensure there is no issue that you have to work on. Let's get started. Number one thing, which is the most common thing that everybody is aware about, is if a child is not giving eye contact, it might have little or no eye contact. That when you're talking to your child and your child is not always comfortable looking at your eyes, just looking at somewhere else while you're saying something, the child is talking to you but is not ready to just look at you, talking about an object, for example, and is not ready to look at the object he or she is talking about, or you are showing your child an object and your child is not ready to look at that object. These are signs you have to watch out for. It might need you to confirm with your doctor if everything is okay. And don't forget, don't wait. Early intervention is always the key, is always the best. So watch out for that. If your child is not giving eye contact, your child is not giving eye contact, maybe little or no eye contact at all, is a thing that you have to watch out for and try to work on that. Also, if your child is interested in playing in a particular part of a toy, for example, a truck or a car, but your child is always interested in turning the wheel, only the wheel, day in, day out, anytime your child is with that particular car or a truck or any toy with wheel, he or she is just interested in playing with that wheel, no other part, only that particular part, is an alarming sign, is a thing that you have to confirm that hopefully there's nothing wrong. I said it in my last video that autism is not actually a disability, it's a special ability. So the earlier you realize that, the better for any child who might be on the spectrum. So watch out for that. In case you're concerned, kindly check with a specialist or a pediatrician. Also, if a child is less concerned, doesn't show any empathy, doesn't show, like, if you're doesn't have any sense of empathy, it's a very alarming thing. no empathy at all, no feelings. Even if that child is in pain sometimes, some children don't even know how to express it. They can't show they're in pain, but even yet they are in pain. These are things that you have to watch out for. Another thing is when a parent is smiling at your child, you're communicating with your child, you're giving a smiley face, you are even laughing out loud, but that child, your child is not responding whatsoever. Your child is not responding back, not even trying to show, to imitate your gesture, to even try to smile back. Whatever object you're trying to play with your child, you're trying to play laughing out loud with your little baby or your little child, but there is no response. These are not a sign that we should overlook. They're a sign that you have to look closely to ensure you give your child the best. No empathy, no feelings, no signs of showing any feelings whatsoever towards self or towards another. These are signs that you really have to look into to ensure that everything goes well with your child. Difficulty in making friends or keeping friends. This is a sign that you have to look into. Very difficult to keep friends. Very difficult to see a child that he or she plays with before and still play, go ahead and make friends or keep friends. These are signs that we have to look out for. If a child is less likely to point at objects, like a child wants water, even though there is no speech, that a child cannot communicate, but he can, if the child cannot point at object needed, it's not a good sign. A child should be able to point at object, I want, even if you cannot talk, you'll be able to know that the child is showing something. Sharing, you know, a lot of kids find it to share. However, some children cannot stand this. They throw very bad tantrum when it comes to sharing with others. These are not so, it's to have tantrum is normal for children. To have difficulty in sharing is normal for children, but when it comes to the extreme of it, so it's something that you have to watch out for, especially if a child cannot point at an object needed. A child should be able to point at an object needed. If a child says no single word at 15 months or two words at 24 months, it is a sign that you have to look out for to ensure everything is okay, there's no speech delay. 15-month-old child should be able to say a word, and 24-month-old child should be able to say at least two words together. So please watch out for that so that you know. Don't forget, early intervention is the key. If it is just speech delay or there's something else there, if it is just speech delay, when you confirm or you check from your pediatrician or a specialist, they'll be able to guide you and you'll be able to start the speech therapy early. The earlier, the better. Don't wait. If a child is repeating exactly what he or she is hearing, for example, if I ask a child, how are you? Instead of the child to tell me, fine, thank you, for example, for age 3. And the 3 years is still saying, how are you? He's saying, what's your name? Instead of answering the question, repeating back the same word. It's called echolalia or echoing. So you have to look out for this. Echolalia is not just a normal thing. No understanding at all, just repeating what is being asked or what is being said. No signs of understanding, and you can even see that there is no understanding. But you can say, my child is okay. You know, this particular thing is something that a lot of people tend to relax about. My child is speaking. At least if I say it, my child is trying to repeat. But don't forget, if there is no understanding, it's an alarming situation. Hello, hello, how are you? How are you? With joy, and the child is okay. It's echolalia. You need to check with a specialist or a pediatrician to know exactly how to go about that. Because I know a lot of people have worked with parents who have said, but my child is talking. Oh, what do you see about this? If I say this, my child is trying. I think my child is trying to learn the words. That's why my child is repeating everything I'm saying. However, if your child is just repeating everything is being said to her, without any understanding, it's something that you have to quickly check and work on. May not cry if in pain or show any signs of fear. Even when a child is close to danger, something that is harmful. I know children sometimes they don't understand, but there's this little sense every child should have that they are moving close to something very dangerous and your child is not aware that this is very dangerous. Is something that you have to look out for. No signs of fear no pain, even if the child falls and is bleeding and the child is not even crying, no signs of feeling the pain or showing signs of fear, is something that you might need to check to ensure everything is right. If a child is very sensitive to sensorial things or not sensitive at all, maybe the sound, maybe it's just irritated with sound. If a child is just irritated with sound, cannot stand the noise, it's just everywhere is noisy, or just holding the ears, or maybe it's a soft carpet or something, soft toy, and your child cannot just stand touching the soft toy. There's sensory issues. These are things that you really need to check so that you can know how to take care of your child very well. From my experience being an early year teacher, I've come to realize, even from research, that every human being somehow is on the spectrum. There's always something somewhere, somehow. And that is why I said at the beginning of this video that these signs and these things that I'm mentioning does not mean your child is autistic. It doesn't mean that your child is on the spectrum. But if you're worried or concerned, it's always good for you to check. It's always good for you to check so that you can give early intervention. So there's always something somewhere. As long as you are not worried, it's not something that is alarming, then fine. But if it's something that you know within yourself that my child of 3 years should be able to achieve this milestone and is not there, you should go ahead and check with a pediatrician or a specialist that can guide you through and tell you what exactly to do. Don't forget, it's not about giving your child the best. Early intervention. One day, one extra day can build a wall. A wall that you can easily break. The more you wait, every day the wall is building. The wall is building. The wall is building. The wall is building. Don't forget, if you want to break a wall and it's just one block, it's easy for you to just break down. But you want to break the wall, but you are not breaking it, but you're building it. The every day counts in the life of a special needs child. The wall is building up, it's building. But if you start breaking the wall, then you can help the child to achieve what he or she is supposed to achieve in life. That is why we cannot overemphasize the word early intervention. If a child has an unusual use of vision or look at object from different angle, sometimes, or a child is not responding to the name. I didn't say that before, I was going to say that earlier. You're calling the child, calling your child's name, your child is not responding. At 2 years, you're calling the child. Even if you want a year old child to be able to respond to the name, even months. That's why I said in my last video, depending on how you've been able to invest your time in the life of your child, every child should be able to respond from as early as 6 months, 8 months, you'll be able to respond. And at least that's my name, that's familiar. But your 3 years old is not responding to his or her name, it's an alarming thing. And you kept calling. However, when there's another sound, your child responds, but not to the name. That is an alarming sign. The child doesn't respond to the name, but responds to every other sound. This is a very alarming thing. Also, another use of vision. If they're looking at something, maybe they're looking at an object this way, but they're just looking at somewhere, but that is what they are really looking at, and they're just saying it. If a child is not responding when you teach, not speaking, but yet you can just hear sometimes your child is repeating numbers, saying something amazing to his or herself. These are alarming things. Extremely brilliant words, but just on a random level, talking to herself. And sometimes they just flip the fingers, and just walk around the house. These are things you need to check. They just look at the fingers, they just attach to their fingers, and they just talk to themselves. They just walk around the house, or they are humming. You know, it's like a song, but you can't really hear what the child is saying. But the child is so comfortable and will not sit, only walking around the house. These are signs that you need to check. Check as early as possible. Don't wait. There are thousands of signs that you can see. But I don't just want to say a lot. There's so many things that you know already. There's so many things that we all know. However, I just want to bring out these few signs that I think people don't really give attention to. My child is now humming. My child is humming, and that means my child want to talk now. My child is just hyper, just walking around the house. Your child cannot sit for 2 minutes. Your 3 years old child cannot sit down for 2 minutes to look at you, to listen to instructions. These are signs that you need to check as early as possible. All right, I'm just going to give these few signs today, these few things that you can look out for in case you see such that you need to check if you're concerned. However, these signs do not mean that your child is autistic. Please underline my words. I am not saying when you see these signs, it means autism or your child is on the spectrum. No. But in case you see that it's getting extreme, I will advise you to check with a pediatrician or a specialist that is going to evaluate your child and tell you what else to do or what next to do, because early intervention is the key. Thank you for joining me on this amazing episode of Parenting Essentials. And I believe you've been able to get a point or two on how to track your child and ensure that you give the best in raising that your growing glory that we love to call them on this platform, growing glory. Thank you once again. Don't forget, I said, if you're new here and you have not subscribed, please don't go without clicking the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe button. That is the only way we can support our channel. Please support our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Watch our videos, like, drop your comment, and share with families and friends. And I'll be coming your way next week on another amazing tips on Parenting Essentials. Stay safe and take care of yourself. Love you all. Bye.